deadlift today. So we're going to start with dumbbells and we'll do it with barbell. We're also going to show you the backpack. The major thing is that it is a hinge movement. So Steph is going to start actually just with her thumbs on her thighs. She's going to push her hips back towards the wall behind her and allow her arms to come down so they're beneath her knees. So she's able to get to that much hinge, her shoulders come forward, and then she's going to bend her knees and come to sort of the bottom of her caprice, and she's going to go back up. Now if Steph turns to the side, her hips are going back, her shoulders come forward, she gets past her knees, then she bends, and as you can see, it goes knees, hips, shoulders. She's in that triangle position. If her knees were in line with her hips, she's more in the squat, it's not very comfortable. And then also, if her hips are in line with her shoulders, so all the way back up, in that position, tabletop position, much more hamstring, not so comfortable either, not so positive for actually getting something out of the lift. So now just standing tall, excellent. So now Steph is going to show us with a dumbbell. So she's going to hinge forwards, push her hips back, then she's going to bend, she's going to grab hold of the dumbbell. Now with dumbbells, you want to let the front of the dumbbell touch, because otherwise you're going a bit too low. Then she's going to stand tall, excellent, same movement up, and then hips go back, and hinge and bend. And then all the way through, and back through. Nice, so from the side, hips are going back, arms going through, and then bending, and then back up. A nice flat back and a strong core. She's recruiting hamstrings, glutes, and adductors. So now we're going to go through the deadlift with the barbell. So same movement. Steph is going to hinge forward. Her hips are driving back. Shoulders are coming in front of the bar. The minute she's past her knees, she's able to bend. She's going to go down to about the bottom of her caprice and then standing tall. Excellent. Hips are going to drive back again. She gets past her knees and then she bends. Gets to about mid-shin and then standing tall. Now, if she were to just lower, so if you were to just lower, that's it. What do we have in the way? Suddenly we have the knees in the way, and this isn't going to help with a heavy object. Also, we're not recruiting as many muscles as we could. So now she's hinging, gets past the knees, and bends. This is the best way to lift something heavy anatomically. And now we don't always have like dumbbells or barbell, but we always have a backpack. So we work with the MPAC. This uses water bladders to make this bag into a workout piece of equipment. Perfect, it's Kevlar, it's got handles all over it, and you can take these straps off for the shoulders, so suddenly it can be just a workout tool. Now Steph is going to use this, she's going to, same thing, hinge. The minute she's past her knees, she's going to bend, she's going to grab hold of the straps, and then the movement is the same thing. She's going to stand tall, hips come forward, stands tall, and then hips go back, and then bend. Now, the other thing about Steph's position here is her feet are directly beneath her hips, so all of that power is going up. If she's wider, she's not going to be as efficient. Now, this is a great option using this bag instead of dumbbells.